Hey, what's up guys, I'm Dinesh, back with another episode of iGeek's blog, and in this video I'm gonna unravel 20 plus Safari tips which you would love to master. It's time to perfectly optimize Apple's web browser to make it work faster and better for you. So let's get started. First, let's take a look at number of tips to speed up your search experience. And right at the top in this long roundup is the way to take advantage of 3D touch. Just touch and hold the Safari icon to quickly access commonly used stuff like a reading list, bookmarks, and even open a new tab right from the home screen of your iPhone. It's pretty good and I kind of like this neat implementation. So do give it a shot to get into the action a little faster. Next in line is the option to take the preview of a page and also get multiple useful options without having to leave that page. Just touch and hold a URL to get the preview of a page. Then you can swipe up to reveal options like open in background, add to reading list, copy and share. That's yet another little but a very effective trick that can smoothen up your web browsing in Safari. Frankly speaking, this tip does sound quite simple, but I think that not everyone knows it. And that's why I have included it in the roundup. When you have copied a URL to the clipboard, just touch and hold the address bar and then hit paste and go. Likewise, you can use this same trick to search anything a bit faster. After copying any text, touch and hold the address bar, then hit paste and search. There you go, as you can see how handy this little thing can be in letting you search faster. Next up, I would like to show you a quick way to enter top level domains in the search bar. Simply touch and hold the tiny dot button in the bottom row of the keyboard and then choose from several top level domains extensions such as .com, .net and .org. This is just the tip of the iceberg as the stock keyboard has many tricks up its sleeve. To discover more about such cool keyboard tips, do check out our hands-on video from the description down below. Now comes a really productive and time-saving hack. Safari is quite smart in learning how the built-in search of a site works, and it creates a shortcut to let you quickly access the content of a site without even having to go there. To get going, I'm going to try out this shortcut on my site. What I'm going to do is hit the search button and enter any search term like iPad Pro, and then hit the result when it appears. From now onwards, I just need to type in our site name followed by the search term in the Safari's address bar. It will suggest something like search igeeksblog.com for iPad Pro in the suggestions box. Simply hit it to get the quick search results. While navigating through web pages, at times I have to look for a specific word or a term. And that's the time when I use these incredible useful features to quickly search within a web page. Suppose I want to search iOS on one of my articles, I just need to tap on the smart search bar and type in iOS. Now scroll down a bit and check out on this page and the number of matches and then hit find iOS. Next, it will highlight iOS on this web page. I can use the upward or downward arrow to navigate through the highlighted word on this page. And in the end, tap on the done to finish. Alternatively, I can also hit the share icon and choose find on page in the share sheet. Then it's a business as usual. While reading an article, you have scrolled all the way to the bottom. How would you quickly jump back to the top of the page? By scrolling up? That's not productive at all. The smarter way to get it done is just by double tapping the status bar at the top of the screen. It works reliably and makes web browsing a bit smooth sailing. Did you know that Siri could help you set a reminder to check out a web page at a specific time? Just invoke Siri and say something like, "Remind me to look at this page today at 9 PM. Siri will confirm that and it will do the assigned task. Now you will get the reminder at the set time to check out that article. I often use these features to catch up with my favorite articles at a convenient time. And I would recommend you to use it as well because it's so very user friendly. While browsing the web, you have gone several pages deep and now want to quickly access all the backward history. What will you do normally? Keep tapping on the backward button? No, that's not the better way to go about it. Simply touch and hold the back button. Now you will see all of your backward history. Similarly, you can touch and hold the forward button to view all of your forward history. So the next time you want to go back and forth while browsing the web, do not forget to use this nifty trick. If you like listening to audio while browsing the web, this tip is for you. Assume a video is playing in Safari, then press the home button or swipe up from the home bar. Now the video will pause. Bring up control center and hit the play button. The video will start playing again in the background. Keep in mind, YouTube doesn't support these features officially. However, there are some tricks to overcome this hurdle. To find out how they work, check out our hands-on guide from the description down below. Not all the sites are perfectly optimized for mobile devices. To be honest, I have come across many websites which look cramped out on mobile devices. Thankfully, there is an option to request the desktop version of a site. What you have to do is simply touch and hold the tiny refresh button at the top right and choose Request Desktop Site. Alternately, hit the share icon and then choose Request Desktop Site in the share sheet. And boom, Safari will instantly present you the desktop version of the site. Unfortunately, there is no quick way to go back to the mobile version. To do so, you need to head over to Settings app, then scroll down and tap on Safari. Now hit Advanced and tap on Website Data. Then find the specific site which desktop version you had requested. After that, swipe left from right on the website data and hit the delete button. Now you will see the mobile version of the site in the web browser. Come on, Apple, you have got to fix this huge pain in the back sooner than later. Google is set as the default search engine in Safari. However, you can choose to change it as and when you want. All you need to do is launch Settings app and hit Safari, then tap on Search Engine. Now you have multiple options like Google, Yahoo, Bing, DuckDuckGo. So choose the one you want to use and you are ready to go. It's time to embrace multitasking to carry out multiple tasks at once on your iPad. You can make the best use of the split view to put two tabs side by side in Safari. To activate it, ensure that your iPad is in landscape mode and then touch and hold the tab icons at the top right. Next, choose Open Split View. Alternately, you can also just drag a link and drop it in the right or the left side of the screen to activate split view mode. That's it, now go ahead and work on both the tabs simultaneously and seamlessly. If you want to master multitasking on your iPad, do check out our hands-on video from the description down below. Now let's take a look at number of tips to take control of tabs. Especially during extensive research, I like to keep tabs in the right order as it makes it a bit easier to access the specific ones. To rearrange tabs, fire up Safari and hit the tabs icon. Now you will see all of your open tabs. Simply touch and hold a specific one and drag it at the top or bottom or anywhere you want. Use this simple gesture to keep all of your tabs perfectly organized. The next tip that I am gonna talk about is searching specific tabs. Save it for the time when you have several open tabs and want to quickly jump into specific ones. To do so, hit the tabs icon and then scroll up to reveal the search tabs bar. Next, type in the name of the tab you are looking for. For instance, let me enter iGeek's blog and it will show all the related tabs. That's pretty neat. I don't think most of you would be aware of this secret trick that lets you close all the search tabs. Frankly speaking, I was also not aware of this hack until I stumbled upon it recently. Just touch and hold the cancel button and you will see an option to close all the tabs matching a site. Simply hit it and all the tabs matching that particular site will be gone. After spending plenty of time on web browsing, now you want to close out all of your open tabs so that prying eyes can figure out what you are up to. Simply touch and hold the tabs icon, then hit the close all tabs and boom, all the open tabs will be gone. Alternately, you can also hit the tabs icon once, then touch and hold done button, finally hit close all tabs and they will go away. After closing all the tabs, I realized I needed to check out some specific ones, and that's the time when this tip comes into the scene. To reopen recently closed tabs, hit the tabs icon and then touch and hold the plus button. Now you will see the list of all the tabs you had recently closed. Just tap on the one that you want to reopen. Next, select the one you want to use. This one is one of my favorite features that have come with iOS 12. I like adding favicons to Safari tabs because it makes a tad easier to spot a specific one. To do so, fire up the settings app, scroll down and hit Safari, then make sure to turn on the switch next to show icons in tabs. Going forward, you will see favicons or website icons in the tabs. Now is the time to take a look at the number of tips to make your browsing private and secure. Safari comes with an incognito mode to let you search the web with more privacy. The best part about it is that when you enter this mode, the web browser doesn't store any of your data. To invoke this mode, tap the tabs icon and then hit private. Next, make sure to tap on done to confirm. When you want to disable the private browsing mode, simply repeat the same steps I had just mentioned, and the general web browsing mode will be back. Moving on, make sure to clear out cookies and history from time to time to prevent the app from being cluttered. And yeah, it can also prevent others from guessing what sort of stuff you are browsing these days. To clean it up, launch Settings app, scroll down and hit Safari. Then tap on Clear History and Website Data and then confirm it. Now all of your browsing data will be wiped out for good. Every time you want to log into any website account, you don't need to enter the passwords manually. To take advantage of these features, ensure that autofill password switch is on inside the passwords and account settings. Going forward, the first time you log into an account, you will get the option to save it to the iCloud keychain. Now the moment you start entering your login credentials, the keyboard will automatically pop up your saved account. Tap on it and all the details will be instantly filled in. The latest version of iOS has made the process of entering verification codes very simple. All you have got to do is just hit the text field and then tap on the incoming verification code to autofill the confirmation box. That's really very user friendly. Now let's enhance your reading experience with these upcoming tips. While browsing the web, whenever I stumble upon an article, I like to drop it into my special collection. That's when the option to convert a web page into PDF comes into the picture. Let's say I want to convert this web page into PDF, I will tap on the share button and then choose create PDF in the share sheet. Then I have the option to annotate the file using the markup tool and save it to the files app. That's pretty intuitive iOS feature. If you are a voracious reader, this tip is for you. The next time you want to save an article to read it later, touch and hold the tiny little icon that looks like an open book and choose add to reading list in the menu. In the same tiny menu, there is also an option to add bookmark. Take advantage of it to easily access a web page whenever you want. That's all guys, the video was really long and thanks a lot for being with me throughout. If I miss out any of your favorite tricks, toss up your comments down below. And if you find this video helpful, like and share it, and do subscribe to our YouTube channel to easily access our latest hands-on guides, reviews, and more. I am Dhune signing off, and we'll catch you in the next one.